Driving east of the mother city, Montague lies on the renowned R62 food and wine route. One of the pearls in this oyster is the Jonkmanshof Guesthouse, owned and run by Chef Jacques Erasmus. Along with his partner and co-owner Hein Liebenberg, he sets the bar when it comes to being a taste master.
Jacques, you have such a diverse set of skills, and I'm told your first love was food. But how did that evolve into a love for art and design?
Both for food as well as design, I think it's all part of the same principle. You know, I think it's all about creating beauty, about the creative process, about finding inspiration from what is around you, and basically rearranging those inspirational things to be creative and to create something from that.
Does this philosophy continue into the kitchen?
Absolutely. The kitchen is really the heart of the house. It's how I also grew up. And in creating this as a very special home, one of the key considerations was to try and recreate that emotion of a kitchen being truly the heart of the house.
Do you use the same approach when it comes to your food?
Yes. You cannot cook without being emotional about it. You know, I think it's all part of a passion for quality, a passion for craftsmanship.
Hein, being a great taste master is not only about cooking and creating good events. What are some of the characteristics that make Jacques an amazing taste master?
I think his sense of detail, he's fantastic in the detail of what he creates. And then he's got a natural flair for when he puts a meal together to know what ingredients should go together and using the freshest produce and what is seasonal. And by just creating a whole atmosphere where people enjoy the meal in terms of the passion and that he portrays in that dish.
Who do you think should enter the Taste Master essay and what qualities should they have?
Most importantly, perhaps, is that they have to be true to themselves, to be able to share their passion with the world and with the viewer. Also someone that, you know, that comes, I think, with a wonderful energy, excitement, somebody that can basically enlighten a sense of passion to the viewer out there.
Since home food is all about the authenticity of the ingredients, they grow their own. As for Jacques' kitchen, chef always welcomes company.
When did you discover your passion for food?
Well, my very first fond memories of food is waking up in a house that smells of bread being taken out of the oven. So, which brings me to what I'll be making for you today, which is a bread from the oven.
Starting with coarse ground organic flour. Add sea salt, lukewarm water, a good olive oil, and then a sourdough starter, which has been fermenting for 2 days and acts as a natural yeast. Kneading in the walnuts and raisins is a serious workout.
It's quite sticky.
Yes, so it's got to be a little bit softer than normal bread dough, I suppose,
yeah.
Because we've put a lot of delicious raisins and walnuts in there.
Jacques had another bread he'd left to rise and double in size over 2 hours. To shape it, he used a bowl covered in cloth, dressed in flour, and left to rest for another 2 hours.
So this is one of my most prized possessions. It's a 300-year-old bread paddle.
Wow.
From Eastern Europe. And this is what we're going to use to put the bread into the wood-fired oven. So after 2 hours, our bread is looking beautifully risen. And this is where the fig leaves comes in. So basically, the fig leaves will give the beautiful flavor to the bread while it's baking in the oven and actually prevent the bread from burning at the bottom because it's such a dense loaf, it will take about 2 hours in the oven.
Does it matter which way the leaf is facing?
No, you can do it any way you like. And then we're going to sprinkle a bit of flour on top of the bread paddle just so it slides off a bit easier. And then all for the trick. There we go. That's looking beautiful. And that's being popped into our hot oven.
Thank you.
Enjoying the first Stella of the day is chef's privilege. Perfect for summer and clearly in agreement with Jacques' guests and fellow taste masters, Zola Nene, Shelley Swartz Mvulana, Abigail Donnelly, and Gregory Czarnecki.
Zola, in the spirit of Stella Artois and making occasions super special, what is it that you have brought to complement Jacques' dish?
I brought my very special almond and strawberry tart. Ooh. Yeah, so I brought the dessert contingent of the meal. Yeah. I hope Jacques approves.
You know, you started out as an assistant on Top Billing magazine.
I did.
And have quickly managed to establish yourself as one of the top chefs in South Africa. That's quite a feat.
It is. And this is exactly what Taste Masters is giving somebody an opportunity to do exactly what I did. And this is just propelling them into a position in their career that is just amazing.
Abby, what have you prepared for us today?
I know Jacques loves flowers, so I found some nasturtiums, the last of the nasturtium season growing in the garden. So anchovies are my favorite ingredient. I use them as a seasoning. So I just pounded them with a little bit of butter, chopped nasturtium flowers. You can use the leaves as well. And then just over some steamed green beans, you can use tender stem broccoli, you can do asparagus.
What I'm loving about your dish is not only does it smell great, it also looks amazing. Shelley, as someone who's in the fashion industry, what role does style and image play in being a taste master?
I think one's style automatically correlates organically with their personality. So I think as an extrovert, one who is charismatic and comfortable in their skin, I think they will succeed with full gusto. And I think getting dressed up and feeling and looking beautiful kind of works with how you would dress a beautiful salad. They all kind of work hand in hand together.
Spoken like an amazing host. You've entertained a lot of people. What are some of the keys to doing that right?
You know, I think my organizational skills from the beginning to the end in terms of the journey, when your guests arrive, and really making guests feel comfortable in your home. I think that's critical. You set the tone to a really successful evening.
All your dishes look amazing, but Greg, what did you bring?
I brought the beers. That's the important part of the meal.
The Stella Artois, making every occasion special, right?
That's correct.
You're one of the main judges for the Taste Master essay. What are you looking forward to?
I think I'm looking at creativity, and also I want people to get out of their comfort zone. You know, I think if you have a passion for food, you need to showcase it and get out of your comfort zone and prove that you can do it for yourself, but also for other people.
The success of Jacques and Heinz Guesthouse is in creating this kind of memorable experience.
What are some of the ingredients that the people entering need to have in order to be a chef presenter?
I think to be the ultimate taste master, you first of all have to have a passion for food. You have to be a foodie and immerse yourself in food in some sort of way. Also, personality is really important because you're presenting food after all. You're on television. People want to see charisma. They want to see whatever you have to offer in terms of personality. So I think that those are the two main things. And also, you don't have to be a professional chef. You just have to have a love for food. So you could be, you know, somebody who's been baking for fun forever, somebody who loves to cook for their family. You could be a professional chef. It's all in your personality and how you show us you through your food.
Do you have a knack for creating special occasions? Would you like to be the next resident foodie on Afternoon Express? Then enter the Taste Master essay on SABC3. Shall we have some dessert?
Let's have dessert.
This is Jacques' view on entertaining. Take the fussiness out of cooking and bring food home to people. Our question is, what's your approach?